The greatest explorer of Ireland, Sir Ernest Shackleton, once said, "I chose life over death for myself and my friends. I believe it is in our nature to explore, to reach out into the unknown. The only true failure would be not to explore at all." Shackleton was a courageous leader who used the power of positive morale and putting others above himself to keep his crew alive while stranded off the coast of Antarctica. During the early 1900s, Sir Ernest Shackleton voyaged to Antarctica from England on his transantarctic expedition to explore the South Pole and cross the continent of Antarctica. Tragedy struck when Shackleton's ship sank, yet his valorous leadership and heroic perseverance triumphantly made survival possible. He exemplified an ideal leader, one of servitude and determination for those after him to follow. Expert Joe O'Farrell, who is currently on the board of directors at the Shackleton Museum in Attai, County Kildare, Ireland, comments that,
"What you would have to admire is so many aspects of his personality, mainly that he put the goodwill of his men above himself."
While Sir Ernest Shackleton's transantarctic expedition of 1914 tragically did not accomplish its original goals to cross the Antarctic, it remains remarkable and triumphant because of the leadership and heroism displayed by Shackleton while overcoming adversity in life-threatening circumstances. Ernest Shackleton was born February 15, 1874, in County Kildare, Ireland. However, Ernest grew up in London, England, and there he became fascinated with sailing, for his home was just a block from the harbor. At age 16, Ernest joined the Merchant Marine Service. He worked hard to rise through the ranks, and at age 24, he was then promoted to the Royal Navy, allowing him the ability to command any ship in the British naval fleet. With his newly gained titles, Ernest sailed around the world for 4 years, gaining valuable experience and growing his skills as a captain. Between the years 1901 and 1909, he facilitated both the Discovery and Nimrod expeditions. Tragically, both trips were deemed as failures due to having to return home early. However, when Ernest returned home, he was elected into the Scottish Royal Geographical Society, ran for Parliament in Dundee, and began a happy marriage with Emily Dorman. Although Shackleton had just failed his expeditions, he made the best out of the situation. "Difficulties are just things to overcome after all," Ernest said upon returning home after the Nimrod expedition. Ernest Shackleton's early life and career helped build his steely character and leadership skills, which ultimately enabled triumph to rise out of tragedy on the future transantarctic expedition. Ernest Shackleton was now recognized globally for his captainship, so much so that the captain of the Titanic sought him out for advice. In 1912, Captain Edward John Smith of the Titanic consulted Shackleton about his experience with ice in the North Atlantic. This shows how respected Shackleton was. That same year, Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen got to the South Pole first. Shackleton claimed it was not the end of Antarctic exploration, and so he announced the Imperial Transantarctic Expedition Project that consisted of traversing the continent of Antarctica via the Weddell Sea and along the way reaching the South Pole on foot. It would be a trip to claim Britain's conquest in the Arctic, map Antarctica's coastline, and perform scientific research on the climate and animals there. Shackleton selected the ship, the Endurance, raised the funds and public support, and gathered 27 capable men for the mission. The plan was to leave harbor from Plymouth, England, refuel at Grytviken, South Georgia Island, sail across the Weddell Sea, and then trek to McMurdo on the other side of the continent. In 1914, only 11 days after World War I broke out, the Endurance set sail on the 8th of August before the expedition could be altered. The Endurance refueled at Grytviken as planned, and then continued the journey to the Weddell Sea. After weeks of fighting through hundreds of miles of heavy ice, on January 18, 1915, ice trapped the ship. Shackleton wrote in his journal, "To a sailor, his ship is more than a floating home, and in the Endurance I had centered ambitions, hopes, and desires. Now was not the time to give in." Seeing that the ship was no longer safe to stay in because of the pressure on the hull, Shackleton took action. He had all supplies and the three lifeboats removed off the ship and ordered the men to set up ocean camp, which would be called home for the next 11 months. Now that Shackleton's ship was frozen in ice, the idea of reaching the South Pole was looking grim, and the question of how long the food supply would last was an ever-growing concern. Despite all these difficulties, Shackleton boosted the crew's spirits by keeping a strict daily routine, encouraging singing and dancing, and organizing football games. In order to survive, the men ate seals, penguins, and even their own sled dogs. Despite temperatures regularly 20 degrees below zero, scant sunlight, and constant blizzards, Shackleton still persisted his faith in rescue. He wrote in his journal, "The men had worked long hours without the thought of rest, and they deserve success. I have not abandoned hope." Tragically, on November 21st, 1915, the Endurance collapsed and sank to the bottom of the Weddell Sea. Expert Joe O'Farrell explains Shackleton's response.
And on that day, Shackleton detected a severe drop in morale for the men left on Ocean Camp. What did he do? He ordered the cook to make an extra portion of food for all the men that evening, knowing that he was wondering where he might make up that extra portion in the days and weeks to come. But he realized he needed to do something to lift the spirits of his men, and that extra portion of food made all the difference. And at that stage, his sole ambition was to make sure that he got all his men home safely, and he was prepared to do whatever it took to get his men home safely.
Due to shifting ice, Shackleton was forced to relocate camp many times over the course of the next 5 months. The ice floe caused the camp to drift northeast, allowing the impossible to occur. On April 9th, 1916, the crew spotted Elephant Island. Though uninhabited, the crew was thrilled to have finally set foot on dry land. Now with a point of reference, the conclusion was that the nearest inhabited place was South Georgia Island, which was 750 miles away. Taking a lifeboat, Shackleton and five other men set off on the 24th of April, bound for South Georgia Island. Battling 50-foot waves, frostbite, and leaky lifeboat, the men managed to cover 60 to 70 miles a day with the tiny vessel. Almost a month later, on May 15th, they reached South Georgia Island. It wasn't long until the men realized they were beached on the wrong side of the island, and so they began the 3-day journey over uncharted and dangerous land, a feat unable to be replicated even with modern technology. On May 23rd, the men met the whalers at the harbor. It was truly a miracle. With assistance from the Uruguayan and Chilean governments, Shackleton was lent the steam tug, Yelcho. Almost 2 months later, on August 30th, the Yelcho rescued the remaining 22 men on Elephant Island. All 28 men returned home safely in January of 1917. The fact all 28 men of the crew survived nearly 2 years stranded without communication to the outside world proves the effectiveness of Shackleton's leadership. The heroism shown throughout the journey demonstrates why Shackleton's transantarctic expedition was a triumph, even though the original goals were not completed. Ernest Shackleton has become a symbol of resilience and fortitude to leaders around the world today. He has been named the greatest explorer of Ireland and has received over 10 global awards. Expert Joe O'Farrell states,
"The Norwegian Roald Amundsen, who was the first man to reach the South Pole, would say that there was never a finer polar explorer than Ernest Shackleton."
Shackleton and his crew's amazing survival story validates the impact of his character and leadership. Shackleton demonstrated sheer determination, loyalty, and grit, all while prioritizing his team's well-being. His tactics are used today as a model in organizations and companies around the world, such as the United States Navy and Harvard Business School. Ernest Shackleton's remarkable story leaves his legacy that one can triumph over any adversity, even in the midst of death itself.